Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In continuation to our lecture series on environmental sciences, I am going to explain you today another topic which is very interesting, that is about the forest ecosystem. In my last lectures, we studied about the ecosystem and the different structures of the ecosystem. So before proceeding to the forest ecosystem, I want to all of you to recap about what is an ecosystem. So ecosystem is basically the combination of living and non-living things in relation to their environment. Living here refers to all the flora and fauna which is surviving, and non-living things like soil, weather, temperature, all the things in relation to the environmental conditions. So living non-living things along with the environmental conditions forms the ecosystem. Now there are various different structures of the ecosystem which we studied, that was about ranging from the producers to primary consumers to secondary consumers to tertiary consumers, and then finally broken down by the decomposers, and the cycle goes on. So now let us try to understand about the forest ecosystem. So when we think about the forest, what is the first thing we get into our mind is the beautiful large area of the land which is surrounded by beautiful trees, surroundings, flowers and birds, all the living life over there ranging from very small to very big animals. So the forest ecosystem basically describes the community of the plants, animals, microbes and all other organisms in interactions. So they all sort of the organisms are related to each other. We also discussed in our previous video about the structure of the ecosystem. All the organisms are dependent on each other. If any component of food chain is being disturbed, the whole food chain gets disturbed. So all the features, they are into the interaction level. One more thing which we discussed in our previous video was about the what do you call the perfection. There is nothing perfect ecosystem. There is no ecosystem which we can say it is a perfect ecosystem, because the interdependency is so much. So like every ecosystem is dependent on another ecosystem which may be dependent on another big ecosystem. So everything works in coordination. So the organisms involved in the forest ecosystem definitions are interdependent on one another for their survival, and accordingly can be classified into different categories. So when we talk about the forest ecosystem, we have again the same hierarchy which we studied in the structure of the ecosystem. So we once again we start from the producers. So here producers in the forest ecosystems are the large plants. We have different kinds of the plants. We have different types of the trees that may range very long trees, and below these long trees comes the canopy of the trees. Then there are grasslands. There are different types of the, ranging from small trees to big trees, different kinds of the trees which are providing shelter to large number of organisms, ranging from birds, reptiles, various different kinds of the organisms live in the this forest ecosystem for their survival. So when we talk about the forest ecosystem is basically divided into three types. First is the tropical rainforest, second comes the deciduous forest, and third is the coniferous forest. So coniferous, let us first discuss about the coniferous rainforest. As the name suggests, they are the forest which are actually situated near the equator line. So they are very lying into the hot and dry regions. They receive large amount of rainfall, around 100 centimeters, and the variety of flora and fauna which flourish in this area is totally different from the other types like deciduous forest or like the coniferous forest. So in the deciduous forest comes the temperate zone. After the tropical rainforest comes the temperate zone. Temperance means that the weather is not that much extreme hot. It is temperate, and all the seasons are visible in the deciduous forest. Now deciduous forest, like we have also been like different kind of the forest, like seasonal forest or like grassland systems. Now and last is the coniferous forest. As the name suggests, they are refers to the regions which are very dried, which are very, very, very dry and very having less rainfall. So when they have the less rainfall and the region is dry, the flora and flora flourishing in that area is totally different from the tropical rainforest and the deciduous rainforest. So actually the weather conditions, actually the temperature conditions, actually the different kinds of the soil conditions dictate the types of the flora, the types of the fauna which flourish there. So different types of the plants are totally different, and like animals surviving in that temperature is totally different. So when we talk about the hierarchy again in the forest ecosystem, it follows the same like that we discussed in the structure of the ecosystem. So again in the structure of the ecosystem, we first discussed about the producers. So here also we are going to start from the producer itself. So what are the producers? Producers, we refer simply to the green plants, which are not dependent on anyone. They produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis and are known as the producers of a forest ecosystem. So again, in the tropical rainforest of Amazon, typically arrange themselves basically into four layers. You know what, 20% of the earth oxygen comes from the Amazon forest. It is such a thick and dense forest, providing examples. It is one of the best forest in the whole world, providing large amount of the oxygen to the whole world. So when we talk about the Amazon forest, there are four different layers in which the plant species are actually growing. So the first would be the emergent layer, top layer, which comprises of very tall trees ranging from 165 feet or more, then that are spaced far apart. So you can see the longest trees that will come into this category. So below these trees comes the canopy. The term canopy basically means like providing a roof like structure. So beneath these large heighted trees lies the canopy, which is composed of closely spaced. You can see the emergent layer was having some sort of a distance, but in these canopy structure, the trees are placed very close to each other and the height is lower than that height, and it lies into the range of 65 to 165 feet tall. So again, they provide large number of the fruits, nectar, seeds for many creatures. You can just visualize the type of the living organism surviving beneath these beautiful forest. So the understory supports few plants as it receives very little sunlight. Because first layer is being occupied by the emergent layer, below the emergent layer lies the canopy, and below the canopy lies this understory support system, which actually receives very less sunlight. So almost nothing grows on the forest floor as it is devoid of sunlight. When we talk about the large forest ecosystem like Amazon, the sunlight is not able to penetrate the ground. So all the dead organisms, dead living organisms, it is lying with a huge layer of the decomposers, scavengers, which we discussed in the last video. So you can understand that is again a very important role which is being played by the decomposers. So they actually complete the cycle. We can imagine a system when there is no decomposers, the environment would not be that clean. Recycling of environment is actually done by the scavengers. So after producers, again like in the hierarchy of the structure of ecosystems, comes the herbivores. So they are the first one to feed upon the producers. So energy levels, I have discussed in the previous video as well, the energy level decreases as we move along up to the system to the carnivores. So the energy which is first of all entrapped by the plants is then taken by the herbivores. They feed on all the types of the green plants and they depend for their survival on the plants. So herbivores may eat a wide variety of different plant material depending on their physical adaptations and their habit preferences. So in the Amazon, a semi-aquatic rodent known as capybara forages on the forest floor and in wetlands for grasses and water plants. There are large number of examples that you will explore and find out that herbivores are feeding on different kinds of the animal plants for as per their adaptations, as per their habit preferences. Other primary consumers such as the red howler monkey, this is specific examples of Amazon forest which live in the rainforest canopy and feed on the leaves, flowers, fruits and nuts of the trees. So you can understand. Next, we move on to the secondary consumers or tertiary consumers, which comprises of the hardcore carnivorous animals. So these meat-eating animals are known as carnivores, and many act both as a secondary as well as the tertiary consumers. So again, they depend on them for their survivals. This is the pic of a jaguar, the biggest mammalian carnivore in the Amazon, which feed on the capybaras, a primary consumer, but also readily hunts such as secondary consumers as caimans, in which case a carnivore eating a carnivore. Carnivore is being fed up by the carnivore. So it plays the role of a tertiary consumers. There are large number of species being found. It is very rich in both flora as well as the fauna. So this is the an example of the golden lion tamarin, a small monkey which eats both fruits as well as the insects and frogs. So such consumers are known as omnivores. Now comes the last category, predators, which thrive in all the areas of these large forests like Amazon, ocelots and jaguars. They hunt for mammals, reptiles, birds on the forest floor and understory. So they actually clean the system. They feed on the dead plants and animals, and they make the cycle complete. They actually clean the system. So you can hereby understand the example of these millipedias and earthworms, which feed on the dead plants and animals and again return back the nutrients to the soil. So you can understand sunlight along with the soil made the first producers, and later on the energy was transferred from the different chain levels, and again we are reverting this back nutrients to back to the plants to be used again by the plants. So the cycle is complete in this respect. It not only these earthworm, there are thousands of species which feed on the dead plants and animals and actually clean the system. So the warm and the moist climate of the Amazon is very conducive for the decomposers to work at a rapid pace. So dead matter is broken down within 6 weeks. This is just an example. It ranges from many weeks for depending on the what type of organisms we are talking about. Since it is very difficult to cover all types of the species over here, these are just few examples, and you may also explore other types of the minor ecosystem working in a major ecosystem. So last thing which I wanted to share with you, whenever we talk about any ecosystem, suppose forest ecosystem, we have to understand the type of the flora, fauna, and what are the varying factors. Like for forest, there are different kinds of the trees, different kind. They are actually on the basis of the type of the environment we talk about. Similarly, like for example, temperate tropical region, temperate region. So what are the temperature conditions prevailing over there? So along with that, the environment is totally made along with that. Similarly, the animals surviving over in that particular regions adapt to that environment, and along with that, an interdependent food chain is being formed. So there is sort of interdependence and symbiosis, which is part and parcel of any ecosystem. For example, in this regard is the relationship between Azetica ants and Cecropia trees. So what is this combination is about? Each ant is also helping the trees to be fed up by their roots, and trees also give shelter to the ants. So trees are giving shelter to the ants, and in relation, ants are protecting the plant to be fed up by the other organisms, their leaves and everything. So they both are helping each other. Similar type of many symbiosis and interdependence are seen in various large forests, which is actually a support system for that ecosystem. So another example of a symbiotic relationship is one between ants and caterpillars, which is being found in these large forests. The ants feed on the sweet juices produced by the spot on the caterpillar's back, and in return they protect the caterpillar from the attack. So this is actually mutual symbiotic relationship whereby each one is helping the other one out. Thank you for watching the video. Please do like, share and subscribe the channel, and keep checking for the updates. Thank you.